Hello everyone, today we will continue with our second chapter, that is control and coordination, in which we will learn about phytohormones. As you know that plant does not possess any kind of neuron cell, any kind of nervous system. Instead of this, they have some hormones which regulate their growth and development. The hormones which are present in the plant, which is called phytohormones, and it helps to regulate the growth and development of plant and its part. According to their function, the phytohormones are of two types. Number one is in group of plant growth regulator, and second part is plant growth inhibitor. Plant growth regulator, from the term plant growth regulator, it means it regulates something. The group of plant hormones which regulate the growth of the plant. And the second definition for plant growth inhibitor, the group of hormones which inhibit the growth of the plant. Starting with the plant growth regulator are of three types: auxin, cytokinin and gibberellins. First going with auxin, auxins are found in the shoot and the tip of the root. It increases the size of the plant and also helps in phototrophic movement of the plant. If you take the example, the particular, as you know that plant move towards the sunlight due to auxin moves when the sunlight drops one side of the plant, the auxin moves towards another side where the sunlight is not coming, and the particular amount it is deposited in this place, and now the plant fold itself towards the light. Second is cytokinin. Cytokinin is the plant hormones which regulate the cell division, cell elongation, and also help in breaking of cell dormancy. And what is cell dormancy? Dormancy means the resting period of the seed. It means when we sprinkle the particular cytokinin hormones, it break the seed dormancy of the particular plant. And the last is gibberellins. Gibberellins is also a plant growth regulator. It also the same function as the cytokinin. It also help in cell division, cell elongation, and also in seed germination. In agriculture, farmer used gibberellin for seed treatment. And now moving towards the plant growth inhibitor, as we already learned this, the growth of group of hormones which inhibit the growth of the plant. First is ethylene. Ethylene is the gaseous hormones which is present, and it's also helping ripening of the fruit because it produces excessive amount of carbon dioxide which change the color of the fruit. And the last one is abscisic acid. Abscisic acid is the hormones which help in wilting of the leaf in the autumn season. Now plant part is completed. Now moving towards control and coordination in human. In human, control and coordination takes place by two systems. First one is nervous system and second one is endocrine system. In nervous system, the nerve cells connect brain and spinal cord, and neuron cell is the structural and functional unit of nervous system. A nervous system is composed of following structure: cyton, dendron, axon. Here I made a diagram of neuron cell. Here a star shaped structure is there which is named as cyton, which possess nucleus on the center and having dense cytoplasm, and there are several branches are there. The several branches are known as dendron, and these dendrons are further divided into dendrites which accept impulses from different part of the body, and after that these dendrites send this impulse to the dendron, and after that dendron send this impulse to the cyton, and next one branch of dendron is larger than the other and named as axon. Axon is made up of three things: axolemma, neurolemma and myelin sheath. Myelin sheath is the outer covering and axon is the present innermost layer, and the neurolemma is present after the axolemma. Here impulses start taken from dendrites, and after that sent to the dendron, and dendron send the impulses to the cyton and cyton send these impulses to the axon, and these axon send these impulses to the spinal cord. If we talk about types of neuron, there are three types of neurons. To learn the new types of neuron, I have a keyword for you, which is SIMRUN, S-I-M-R-U-N. S for sensory, M for motor, and R for relay neuron. Sensory neuron is also known as afferent because it receives impulses from receptor organ and send these impulses to the brain. And motor neuron, also called as efferent neuron, it send impulses from brain to the effector organ. And the last one is relay neuron. It connects sensory neuron to the motor neuron. And now we need to talk about synapse. Synapse, it's a most important topic of the class 10. Maybe it will ask in your paper. The neuron cells are not completely combined to each other. It means one neuron is not connected with the other neuron. The small gap present between two neuron ending cells. The gap between two neuron ending cell is known as synapse. It plays an important role exchange of impulses inside of the body. Now, organs of nervous system. Organs of nervous system consist three part: central nervous system, CNS, peripheral nervous system, PNS, and autonomic system, that is ANS. Central nervous system possesses brain and spinal cord in it, and peripheral nervous system possesses nerves that arises from the central nervous system, and autonomic nervous system, it possesses nerves which arises from different part of the body. Okay, in first we need to learn about brain and spinal cord. Okay, I'm going to make the chart of brain and its part. In central nervous system, the first part is the human brain. Human brain is the highly developed organ present in human body. The weight is about 1.2 to 1.4 kg. We talk about in the gram, it is 1200 to 1400 in gram. It is present in the cranial cavity, which is also called our skull, and the particular is skull. Inside the skull, brain is protected by three layers, and the particular layer is named as meninges. And inside the meninges, cerebrospinal fluid is present, which protect our brain from jerk and shock. If we talk about the cranial capacity of the brain, it is 1400 to 1500 cc. It is a highly developed organ. If you talk about the part of brain having three parts: forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Forebrain, which is the front part of the brain, which is a highly developed part of the brain, having three parts: cerebrum, olfactory lobe, and diencephalon. First is cerebrum, which is a highly developed part of the brain, which help in which is also known as highly developed highly thinking power which having highly developed thinking power capacity. And second, olfactory lobe, which help to smell, to detect the smell. And diencephalon, which help to control temperature, hunger, thirst, and many functions in our body. Second part is midbrain, which is a very small part of the brain, which connect forebrain to the hindbrain, having two lobe, optic lobe and cerebral peduncle. The function of optic lobe to recognize image while moving. It means if object is moving anywhere, with the help of optic lobe, we can easily identify the image and the color of the object. And cerebral peduncle helps in to maintain or coordinate the sensory and motor neurons. And the third part is hindbrain. It's the last part of the brain, having three parts: pons, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata. Pons, as you know that the brain is the having a two hemisphere. Pons help to join these two hemisphere and coordinate the impulses to both side of the hemisphere of the brain. And cerebellum, it control the body posture regularly. If someone consume alcohol and that time the person cannot stand properly, the cerebellum part dismembered, and the last part of the brain is medulla oblongata. It connects brain to the spinal cord. It controls the involuntary action, just like sneezing, coughing, vomiting, heartbeat, and breathing, and many more activity. Now, we are moving towards our next topic, that is spinal cord. Now, spinal cord. Here, I made a diagram of spinal cord, which is just like a strip rod, which is present backside of the body. It is also known as backbone and vertebral column. It is a cord-shaped structure having three components: meninges, cerebrospinal fluid, and adipose. Meninges, which protect the spinal cord or absorb the jerk. Cerebrospinal fluid also protect the spinal cord, and adipose tissue act as cushion for the spinal cord. If you talk about the function of a spinal cord, it conduct impulse from different part of the body and towards the brain, and also the maintain the body posture. It means with the help of spinal cord we can stand properly, and it's also center for reflex action. The question is that what is reflex action? As you feel sometimes particular brain, sometimes the particular actions taking place very smoothly and very fastly, just like blinking of our eyes and jerking of our hand. If mean when we touch any warm material and when we see the particular crackers are bursting in our surrounding, in that time we respond spontaneously. It means when the impulses are not directly sent to the brain, it's regulated by the spinal cord. This kind of action is known as reflex action. Sneezing, coughing, and some more actions are controlled by our spinal cord. This kind of action is known as reflex action. Now, the last part of the particular chapter, second, is our endocrine system, which is very important for class 10. The first MCQs questions are come from that topics. Okay, I'm going to write their names and then we will discuss. First, we need to learn about endocrine system. But before endocrine system, we need to know about what are hormones. In previous classes, may you learn about hormones. Hormones are proteinaceous in nature. They are produced inside our body. They act on their target cell, and after that, if we know more about hormones, they produce in very small quantity, and after the chemical reaction they do not get absorbed in our body, and it regulates the chemical reactions inside our body by which we can show growth and development. In our body, two kinds of system are there. First is endocrine system and second one is exocrine system. Endocrine system is also known as ductless gland. It means they secrete their hormones directly to the blood and through the lymphs. It means there is no duct for secretion of these hormones. And in endocrine system, they are known as ductile gland. It means they secrete their hormones and enzyme by duct. Just like salivary glands are secreted by the duct, and pancreas is also secrete their pancreatic juice or digestive through their duct. Now, moving the total hormones present from the head to toe in our body and their functions. Here I made a diagram which represent where our endocrine and exocrine or different glands are present. From head to toe, near about 10 to 11 glands are there, starting with hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is present in the brain region, which control or which also known as releasing and inhibiting hormones. It control over pituitary gland. Next is pineal gland. Pineal gland is present just behind of hypothalamus. It controls the secretion of melanin pigment. As you know that melanin pigment, which regulate the skin color of the body. If any person having excessive amount of melanin, the color of or complexion of the body is dark in color, and if the amount of melanin is very less, the color of body is fair in color. Next is pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is also known as master gland. because it controls the secretion of all gland. The main hormone secreted by pituitary is GSH, which means growth stimulating hormones. If GSH secreted in hyper, it means excessive form, or over secretion of GSH make the person giant, it means the growth is very high. If lower or hyposecretion of growth stimulating hormones, the person become dwarf. And the next is thyroid, which is present near the vocal cord. It is T-shaped in structure, which produce thyroxine hormones with the help of iodine, which we consume with our food. And by the hyposecretion, it means lower secretion of thyroxine hormones cause goiter, and the over secretion of thyroxine hormones cause thyroidism, which is normally present in females. And the next hormones, the next gland is known as thymus gland, which is present in the middle of the chest cavity, slightly left side. It is active till 13 age, before the puberty age, and it helps to maintain the growth and development of the human body. And after that, growth is regulated by pituitary gland. In thyroid, another gland is there, which is named as parathyroid, which secrete parathormones. These hormones regulate or balance the calcium phosphorus level in our body. Another gland which is present after the stomach, named as liver, which is the largest gland present in our body, which secrete bile juice and help in digestion of fat molecules. Next is pancreas. Pancreas is also known as mixed gland, which secrete insulin hormones. As you learned in nutrition topic, pancreas secrete pancreatic juice, which possess ATL, which means amylase, trypsin and lipase, which help in digestion of various molecules. This particular insulin help to maintain the body glucose level or blood glucose level in our body. Due to hypo and hyper secretion of insulin, it will cause diabetes. And diabetes is out of two types, diabetes mellitus and diabetes insipidus. Hyposecretion causes diabetes mellitus, and hypersecretion will cause hyperglycemia. Next is adrenaline gland, which is also known as emergency hormones, which is named as emergency gland, which secrete adrenaline hormone, which control our body during pretended condition or fear condition, and also maintain our body temperature. And next is our gonad gland, which is to in male testes secreted testosterone, and female estrogen and progesterone are female sex hormone. If we talk about testes, testosterone is a male sex hormone which help in growth of secondary sexual characteristics in male. What are secondary sexual characteristics in male? In after the gaining the puberty age or adolescence, after 13 year age, the secondary sexual characteristics like broad shoulder, beards and mustache arises in their body, hairs arises in their pubic region, and sperm production start from their testes. And in female, estrogen and progesterone, two female sex hormones are there. Estrogen hormones help in secondary sexual characteristics in female, just like pleasant voice, soft skin, start menstruation cycle in their body, and also help in growth of pubic hair in their body. And progesterone help to maintain or development of uterus layer in their body during pregnancy, or also help in development of mammary gland. Okay student, these glands are very important on the in the point of view of your exam. Some I'm going to mark what we will come in your exam as their MCQ: pituitary gland, thyroid gland, and pancreas which secrete insulin. Now, as you learned before, it secrete growth stimulating hormones, hypersecretion cause become person giant, and hyposecretion person become dwarf. And thyroid which secrete thyroxine hormones, which cause goiter and thyroidism. And pancreas which secrete insulin, the normal level of insulin is 90 to 120 mm per liter. It means the lower level before eating any kind of food 90, and after that it 130 to 140 ml per liter. And one more important gland is there, adrenaline, which maintain blood pressure. In your previous classes question paper, questions are arises from blood pressure, and where you need to learn about adrenal gland which secrete adrenaline. This is all about chapter 2. In next my video you will learn about the reproduction in organism. Thank you and have a nice day.